girl. If I'm a stick up kid, I'm pulling out for you, girl. If I was hustling, I'd pump coke for you, girl. If I was a dread, then I'd smoke for you, girl. I play captain, rock the boat for you, girl. I play Martin and bring hope to you, girl. When I was away, look how I wrote to you, girl.
Hello.
Hi.
Say hi to everybody.
Hi.
What's your name?
Ayana.
Actually, your name is Moon752. Tell me your name. Moon752. That's right. Sun752, Moon752. Urban Therapy with Sun752, and this is your daily go getemism number 189 for July 19th, 2015. Today, we're going to talk about when you need a friendly little reminder about things. You know, some things in life we have to be reminded of, even though they're things that theoretically should come second nature, but you know, what comes second nature to one person doesn't always come second nature to another person. And the reality of the situation is many of us have to be taught how to think. Because if you take a young person and you fill their heads and you tell them, you know, all kinds of the wrong stuff and bad stuff, then that's basically how things are going to turn out. You believe that? So you think that if somebody that you trust says, who tells you something, that you might believe what they say, right?
Yeah.
So if they tell you the wrong things to do, then you can get in trouble, right?
Yep.
All right. Do you get in trouble? Every once in a while.
Yeah.
What kind of things do you get in trouble for? Nothing comes to mind right now. What about in school? Do you ever chew gum or eat candy while you're in class? No, never. That's what I used to get in trouble for all the time when I was your age. I always had candy. I like to eat in school. So gum and candy, I would get caught eating that. And sometimes I would get sent to the principal's office because of that.
But I see people get in trouble for
eating stuff. Aha! Just not you? Okay, well that's cool. Well that's good.
Even if it's like really dumb class, they don't my tongue.
Wait, you put the gum under your tongue?
Uh-huh.
What kind of gum you like?
Gum.
Any particular flavor?
Okay.
Oh yeah, it is the same as bubblegum flavor, that's right. Alright. Well, so do you ever forget that you have the gum in your mouth and then, you know, somebody has to remind you to spit it out before the teacher gets it? So you already got this thing smashed, huh?
Yep.
Sometimes we have to be reminded of things, though. So if you take a young person and you tell them the wrong things to do, they're going to think that that's okay because you, as a grown-up, have been telling them what to do. And sometimes many times kids tend to believe what grown-ups say. After all, we're older than them, we're taller than them, and we drive cars and we have money and we take care of them, so why shouldn't they believe the things that we say? So that's why we have to make sure that we remain respectable as people, and that we keep our ducks in a row and remember it's the things that you do that children remember, not necessarily the things that you say. They'll remember the things that you say too, but if you back it up with action, they're going to remember those actions to reinforce those words. So we have to be reminded sometimes to make sure that we act like we have some sense. And like I said, what makes sense to some people doesn't make sense to other people. So we have to be taught exactly how to act and what exactly to do. You know, anytime we're in a new situation, you know, we may practice what to do in order to conduct ourselves. But that doesn't mean that while our adrenaline is pumping and while we are anxious and nervous, that doesn't mean that we won't forget things. And sometimes we forget things. What kind of things do you forget?
Maybe sometimes
you have to be reminded to do your homework?
Yeah.
I used to have to be reminded to do my homework too, especially if I didn't like the subject. What's your favorite subject in school? Math? Math? Math is not hard if you practice. So So do you practice a lot?
Yeah.
Okay. So
and
that's
math, I keep it
a lot of math homework?
Yeah.
That's cool.
It says she built and makes
it. It's easy?
Yeah.
Well, it's probably easy for you because you know how to do it. Aren't there some
people? She gives us a lot.
What about the other students in your class? Do they all think that the homework is easy?
Yeah.
So they're all brainiacs, y'all all just super smart? Yes or no? You don't know anybody that struggles? What about when does your teacher have you read out loud in class? You know, do you have to read from a book out loud?
No.
Never? Okay. When I was growing up, we used to have to read in class. So the teacher would pick out somebody to read to the rest of the class in class. So some people couldn't read that well. So instead of reading like, then the boy and the cow walked into town and went to market and bought a lot of fruits and vegetables and then came back home and then he milked the cow and then late and then ate dinner and went to bed. When the people who struggled to read used to read, it didn't sound like that. It would sound like, and then the boy and the cow went to Market, yeah. And so you understand what I'm saying? So there was some things weren't as easy for everybody as it was for some people. So those people had to be reminded to practice more and to ask questions. Do you ever get nervous about asking questions in school? Everything you want to know, you ask?
Yeah.
That's good. And you know what? You should always ask something if you want to know it. Don't pretend like you know. You know why? Because if you pretend like you know something when you really don't know it, then people think that you know it, and then when it shows that you don't know it, they'll be surprised. Like, well, why didn't you just say that you didn't know it? Why didn't you ask any questions? So it's always good to ask questions. There's no such thing as a stupid question. You understand that? All right. Even though some questions don't sound like good questions, but they are all good questions. Because no matter how crazy the question is, somebody else around you wonders the same thing, but they're probably just afraid to speak up. So, because you're not even afraid to get in front of this camera, I know that you probably aren't afraid to speak in front of people. Ain't that right? Because you're a dancer. Ain't that right? And you're a gymnastics person. Ain't that right? All right. Now, when we ask people, when we have to be reminded of certain things, if y'all don't believe what I'm saying, think about how many times that you're rude or disrespectful to people that frustrates you or get on your nerves. Don't you have to be reminded sometimes to be nice, be kind, be patient of other people's inconsistencies or innuendos or inadequacies? I mean, you know, it happens. It happens. Think about that alarm clock that goes off every morning when you get up. That's a friendly reminder, even though many of us don't even set the alarm clock to be really friendly. It goes off like, and no matter how much it gets on our nerves, what do? We press the snooze bar. Well, y'all press the snooze bar. I never push the snooze bar. I don't get down like that. I don't have an alarm clock, but I have a telephone. There was a time when I didn't have to be reminded to get up on time. It was automatic. Not no more. Well, kinda yeah, kinda no. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, you know, when we have to be reminded of certain things, don't shoot the messenger. If somebody is reminding you of certain things, don't get mad at them. If they're asking you certain questions, you know, try not to get too frustrated with them, especially when you're dealing with young people, because you have to remember that they're young, they're impressionable, and they're watching you. So the things that they're gonna learn are the things that you teach them. So it's very important that we make sure that they feel comfortable and confident about coming to you with their problems. Because what you don't want to happen most of all is that they wind up getting into trouble out there, and then and you find out that the reason that they got in trouble was because they were afraid to come to you. And that's just a friendly reminder from Sun 752 and Moon 752 to you, 75. Yeah. But, you know, anyway. So remember, good things happen to those who wait. Great things happen to those who grind. And anything can happen to those who go for theirs. So go hard, go for yours. And yo, a friendly little reminder to somebody that may be down on may not be on point for that day. Don't get mad at them, just give them a friendly little reminder. And when you're not on point one day, hopefully somebody will come along and give you a friendly reminder of exactly what to do. Two good heads are better than one, not just two heads, but normally two heads. Because I'm not going to say just two heads, because two heads can come up with two bad ideas and or agree on one bad idea, like a bank robbery or murder or something really, really terrible. You know what I'm saying? So not just two heads are better than one, but two good heads are always better than one. So try to align yourself with somebody that has a good head, and hopefully they'll give you a friendly reminder of how to conduct yourself, make sure that you maximize your potential, and become a winner. Because that's what you need to be. Ain't that right?
Yep.
All right. So we out of here. I'll holler at y'all tomorrow. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I mean, you know, baby, we're going to take a little walk in the park. We just came back from skating, so yeah, it is what it is. Out here in beautiful Fairmont Park. It's so beautiful. By the way, this is the park that we'll be starting from next Saturday for the Urban Therapy with Sun Spring Cleaning Event number 4. This is the 4th one. Listen, y'all, I know y'all out there, y'all hear me talking about this healthy stuff every single video. That means every day for the most part. And I know most of y'all want to get in shape. Who don't want to be in shape? Who don't want to feel healthy? Who don't want to lose weight? Who don't want to feel good about themselves? Well, this is where it all starts, man. We do this for free. We give you a good, fun workout, and you get to be around with good people, fun people, very, very personable people that's down for whatever. So come out here July 25th, next Saturday, 10 a.m., Rittenhouse Street and Wissahickon Avenue. Yo, man, and walk with us. We walking through the woods this time. We walking through the woods this time. You're going to love it. You with that, right? You. You down? I know you down. We'll see y'all next Saturday. Peace.
I was poisoned.